Okay, so we don't have need in to take in the what cost, right? We need what in the code section, guys. Okay, so come here. Where the product code, right? Okay, this one inside this one we have need to take what here. Now come to our page now. Okay, yeah, it's came right in the code, right? Whenever we will take the code, it's showing here. It's came, right?
Yes.
So now here let's remove the label. Let's remove the label now. Okay, good. So inside that, inside this one, what we will do now, guys? Let's take one span tag. Okay, span tag. Inside this span tag, what we will do now? Inside this ID, let's take one ID equal to what? Let's define one attribute. What? Prod code, right? Prod code. Code error. Okay, based on this one only we will whenever we will write the logic at the time we will use it. Okay, you people know that, right? ID is there, after then what? Class is there. Based on that we can recognize this tag in
class,
the
class is there. Yes,
yeah, we can recognize in the HTML, CSS, yes. CSS code, HTML code, JavaScript code, in the HTML these things, no, right? Or don't know?
Yes, no.
Sorry.
No, the
no, right?
Yes, no. Yes. Yes, we know.
Okay. So good. So here, what we will do now? Inside this one only, let's create increase one more here also. One ID. ID equal to what? ID equal to what? I'm taking what? Product code. Product code. ID equal to what? Product code. Right. This one also. Okay, good. So both places we increase, right? Both places we increase. Okay, so for that, after then what? Event, we will generate one event, right? Click event, right? Click event for that in the form action, right? In the form action, what we will do now? Here only again increase one more ID. I will use these things, okay, in what to writing the our what Ajax call. For that, what I will take now, my, you can take any choice name, guys. Okay, this name you can take. Okay, my product form. I'm taking what? My product form. Okay, so now fine. Okay, so good. So now come down, right? Come down. Okay, here we will write the JavaScript logic. Okay, let's write it. Ajax, right? Okay, let's write what our Ajax logic here. Okay, guys. So okay, so here what I will do now, script. Script JavaScript now. Okay. So the document JavaScript, guys, totally I'm writing document, document, right? Document. The spelling is correct, right?
Yes, correct.
Dot ready. Ready inside that we will call what? We will in ready, right? Inside that what we will do now? Inside that we will call one function.
Function,
right? Function. Okay, good. So function. Okay, now fine. Okay, so here what we will do now, first step, what we will do now, guys? First step, hide error section, right? Hide error section, it means what? This error section, right? 1 minute. In the page here we are specifying this section is what? Error, right? This section we specified for the error section, right? Error as well as what? Error section, right? If the data is succeeded, then nothing we will get. If error means what? If data is already exist, what means what? This section became what? Error section now on the page. Come on, means what? Already here we will get already, here already we will get the message. Yeah, this data is already there. So for that, what I'm doing?
Data is already there.
Yes. So for that, what? This is the error section. So what is that? What is that product code error? What we taken now, guys? Here, come here. What I took here? 1 minute here. Yeah, product code error, right? This one, right? Come on.
ID.
ID we taken, right? Product code error. Nah, come on. So hide that area, right? So for that, how we will hide it? Dollar symbol inside that. What we will do now? ID. How we are calling the ID tag? No. How we will? How? Okay. Just I will pass it. Then our what? DOM parser will not call, right? DOM parser will not call. Yeah. ID we will call with what?
Hash code.
Hash symbol. Hash symbol. ID we will call with what? Hash symbol. Now guys, okay. So remember.
Has.
Yes. Okay, good. So after then what we will do now in the hide
dot
hide, right?
Hide.
Dot hide one method is there. That's it. Okay. After that, let's perform what next operation. Next operation number what? Second operation, right? Let's perform what? Second operation. What is the second operation now? What is the second operation now? Define error variable. Error variable. Error variable, right? So good. So let's create it. How we are creating the variable in JavaScript, guys? Where, right? Come on.
Yes.
Prod.
Yes, by using where.
Error, right?
Error prod equal to.
Error equal to, just make here by default as false.
False.
By default, make this one as a false now. Okay. Third operation, what we will do now? Third operation, we will take what? Third operation, let's do that. What define? Call what is define variable function, and what is that? We have need to define one variable function, right? So, okay, we have need to define what one variable function. What will be there now? Variable function, guys. So anything mistake? No, it's because it's the lengthy code will go, guys. Okay, variable here. Okay, good. So fine. Yeah. So let's analyze it, guys. 1 minute. Variable function I'm calling is correct. I'm hiding that what error scenario. This one is so good. Okay. So fine, guys. So next. Okay. So let's take one function variable. Function, I'm creating validate, right? Validate what? Validate underscore what? Product code, prod code, right? Okay, this function inside this one, what? This is what? Our function. Okay, inside this function, what? This variable, right? By default, what? True and false I'm taking, right? True and false only I'm taking. So what I'm taking now? So what is the variable name? Product error code, right? So just return it here. Product error code, right? Equal to what? Equal to false by default. If what? If in the, like, I'm going to check what one if condition, guys. Okay, so no, it's still not correct, right? We have need to check if condition. So if I'm checking the condition now, if now in this condition, right? If what is what we will do now? Let's copy this one and paste. Okay. Now, okay. So here, what is that variable, right? So here we will declare one variable again, right? Inside this one more, we will further checking the condition, right? Because we have need to give here if in the if else condition, what we have need to give what product code, right? Here, what is the whatever product code we will put here, right? whatever product code here we will put.
Product code is not.
Yeah, here product code we will give, right? So for that, what we did here, now come here. For that product code ID we given, right? This is the product code ID. Now come here. So here what we will do now, here that product code ID we will take inside, and then again we will create what one where prod code error, right? No, something wrong is going on. We will take that variable, right? Variable, and what is that value? We will read that value, right? Whatever input here we will give, right? Whatever input we will give, first we will read it here in the JavaScript, right? We will read it. Okay, so for that we have need to hold it, right? So how we will hold it now? Okay, equal to in the one variable I'm holding now, guys. Okay, so now dollar symbol inside that, what I'm going to do now? ID, that is the ID, right? So how we will read the ID now? Has symbol
product
ID, right? Product code, like this, right? But that is the value, right? So we have need to read the value, and then we will call the value method.
Dot value.
Yes. Yeah, now it's correct. Based on that, we can able to read that. We can hold that value, whatever value we will put here, right? That value we will hold it here, right? And what we will do now here, if condition we will check empty, right? If while equal to what? If while equal to empty. If value equal to empty means what? You have to put something here. You have to put something here, right? So value equal to what? Empty. Then what we will do now? The error code, right? Error code we will what is that? Show that error code. If empty is there, then what we will show now? Still we will show that how? Then dollar symbol now dot, what is that? Show method is there inside that, what? JavaScript, guys. Okay, show method is there. After then one, let's copy this one. Another one is what? Again dollar symbol dot, what is that? HTML. In the format of HTML we have need to see that. On the HTML page we have need to see that code, right? So what is that? HTML method is there. After then what? Dollar symbol what? Now CSS, on the CSS style, right? I will apply the CSS also. For that also one method is there in the JavaScript, right? So good. So but where we have need to apply it now, guys? In which area? So come to our what already I took, right? So here product error code, right? Product error code in this area means what? Here we have need to apply, right? Here we have need to apply. Based on which tag we will apply it now? What tag only we will apply this? What we will recognize our area now? Come on, guys.
Code.
Yeah. So we will take, yeah, so we will take that code here, right? We will take that code inside this one with, but that is the ID. So what we will take now? Hash symbol here we will paste it. So same like we will paste inside that here also in the, but here means what? Hide, because by default what is that here made? We made what is that? Hidden, that one is hidden. But what is that? If any error is there, then what we have need to show it. Because of that I took this one. After then what? Some message also, right? Some message also we have need. So what I'm going, code, I'm writing what? Code can't be what? Can't be what? Empty, right? Code cannot be empty. After then what? Next one, we have need to red symbol, right? We have need to show the red symbol. Because of that, we taken the CSS method. So here, what I'm going to do now? Here, I'm going to take color. Color, after then what? I want to red color, right? Mm-hmm. Comma, red.
Red.
Okay. So, okay, good. So now, after then what we will do now? We will take the else condition, right? Else condition.
Program.
Yes. Yeah, banana. Kya banana? Video calling ke liye. Kya karne apni? Arey yaar, apni jaan maan dal rahe hain. Pati. Paisa koi.
Okay. So here what else condition? In else condition, what we will do now? In else condition, we will call what is that? We will start what is that? Our Ajax coding. Now here we will start what? Our Ajax coding, right? Ajax coding, right? Start Ajax coding. We will start it, guys. Okay. So now let's start it. Okay. Let's start it. So here, what is that dollar symbol? Dollar symbol dot what? AJAX, right? The method is there inside that. What we will do now? Okay. So let's open bracket and close bracket, right? Inside that we will start that logic. So what is that URL? Colon, what is that? Validate code. What we will do now? Validate code, right? So okay, here what? Validate code. Okay, so one minute, I have need to see the Ajax calling, guys, little bit. One minute, then I will give the clear picture. One minute. Ajax. Just a minute, guys. Okay. Yes, guys. Okay, so come here, right? So here, what is that? See this, okay? See here, what is that URL is we have need, right? Come on, guys, everyone give the response, guys. Based on your response only I can complete this application, guys.
Yes, Ravi. Validate.
Yes, Ravi.
Because validate code. Ajax is not easiest thing, guys. Whatever concept I'm going to implement is, you know, this is the very very critical task. Okay, so but based on your response only I will get what encouragement, guys. Okay, so now here what is that URL? So now come to our controller now, guys. Okay, come to our controller now. What is that validate code?
We took
validate code, right? So now copy this one,
validation code.
Yes, yeah, sir.
Now come here and here we'll take this one as what? Now comma, right? After then what is that? Data, we have need to take what? Data. One more, what is that? Data, right? Data. After then what? Data. What data we will take now? Okay, so val, right? Value, just we specified this value, right? This value we will take that value here only, right? So for that, how we will take that data now, guys? So open bracket, close bracket, open curly bracket and what? Close curly bracket. Inside that what we will take? Do now we will take the code. Yeah. Sorry. Code and what we will take now? This value. Colon this what? Val variable. We will take this variable now.
Okay.
Means whatever input we will take, right? Whatever input we will put, we are holding that input in this variable only, right? In the JavaScript code. Come on.
Yes,
after then based on that, right? Based on that, this data, right? Based on this data, what we will do now? We have need to make the request also, right? Our application will make the request, right? Come on. If based on this
URL, yes, sir.
It will check the URL, right? After then what it will do now? It will take this data, guys. Come on. It will take this data, means what? String data, na? Come on.
Yes, now code now, data, yeah, now, code value.
Yeah, so then what will happen now? It will come to what is that code, right? This one will come to our code parameter or not? Come on, guys.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what I'm doing now, see this, one minute, come here. Okay, see this, here what our farm data is there, right? Here what is that code? Why I took code? Because I took the argument inside that controller, right? Inside that controller, what argument I took now? Code, right?
Code.
So now you got the point why I took here inside that what? Inside that here code. Come on, everyone.
Number
yeah, because we have taken the same, this both should match.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah, that code only here comes as value variable.
Yes. This value means here, if any value we will pass, right? So this value will store in which variable now? Which variable? This variable value, because here
code variable.
Because see this here in the product code only I'm holding, right? And this is the variable to how we are declaring in the JavaScript variable, like using where, right?
By using where.
So what is that? Product code come here, right? Product code in the form here. What I took now here, the ID now, yeah.
Product code ID.
Product name, product code, right? See this here. What I defined now, ID, where ID took 1 minute.
That is 33 line.
Yeah, 33. Yeah, see this here. So this input means what is that? This is the input, product code input, right? So this input for that one only be taken, right? This input now. Come on, everyone.
Got it.
So what I'm doing now, we are holding that value in this variable, and what we are doing now, here we are taking the URI of what our controller, and here see Ajax call I'm going to make now, guys. Okay, and here what I'm going to do now, the data argument is need, right? Argument is need. Come on, this method, this controller
need, now this code will compared in the validation.
Yeah. So now it will come here now. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
It will come here and validate code method will be
executed. Yes. Now after then what? We will get what is that? After executing that block, we will get the response also now. Come on. If our controller will execute successfully, then what successful message we will get, right? Come on. So for that, what we will take now here, one more. Now comma, right? After then what? Success dot function. We will call one function, and inside that what we will do now? We will pass the response. We will pass the response now, guys. Okay. What is that? RESP response. Okay.
Okay.
We will pass the response. Then it will return. What is that? Then it will return what? Success message, guys. Okay. Then it will return what? Success message. But what before that? Before that, something we have need to write again. Means what? Success message also we have need. What is that? If the thing is going good, so what we will do now, again we will check the condition. What if okay, now okay, good. If what? If response is what? If response is what? Response equal to, if response equal to empty, if response equal to empty, then what we will do now, then what we will do now, copy this code, same code only, right? From here to here, and paste it here. Same code only, okay? So, okay, good. So, fine. So, after then, what we will do now? After then, we will again, we will take else condition here. Again, we will check the what success method means what. After then, what we will do now? We will hide. First, if no error is there, right? If error is there, if in the success message also, if in the response also, right? What error is there? Then what we will get? This one is we will get. Else, what we will do now? We will perform the operation. Right. We will hide that. Okay. So, but what is that? How we can hide it now? Dollar symbol. dollar symbol, inside that hash symbol, right? Hash symbol. What is the product error, right? Copy this one. Product error. So how we can hide it? dot hide method is there, okay. After then what we will return in now, we will return what if product code error equal to true. If product error code equal to true here, okay. Now our what? Our Ajax. Yeah. And I have need to check again. Fetch mine. Next operation, what we will do now? So, I'm going to be now. Response, we have to get the response, right? So, response, next one. I'm going to be our application. Then here we will return what? We return what? What error code equal to what? No, fine. Okay, 1 minute. I have need to check because here we started this function. Now, 1 minute. Because from there only we will return it to this function, right? Where this function we started. Our Eclipse ID is showing that document is ready now. This function, okay? So this function is there. Our Eclipse ID is not pointing where that curly bracket, because if curly bracket also means right, then our application will not execute, guys. Okay, so document is there. Here, this one. Sorry, guys, because of network, it's better. Okay, so fine, guys. So the logic is ready, right? The logic is ready now, guys. Okay, so next one is what? Next step, let's do that. Next step, right? So what? Fourth one. Fourth, we will do that. What? Fourth. Fourth operation. Okay, fourth operation. What we will do now? Link with what? Action event, right? Link with what? With what? Action event. Link with what? Our application, we have need to link with what? Action event. So for that, what? Dollar symbol, 1 minute. Dollar symbol, after then what? Hash symbol, after then what? Where we will generate what? Action event. We took what? In the form tag, right? Here, see this, in the form already I took ID, right? My product form, right? So now copy this one. So come here, okay? Come in this section. Now paste it here, because we have need to generate event on what? That form only, right? That form only, because here we are not going to click on that. Our application only will click, right? So now, okay, form event. So for that, good. So next, what we will do now? Okay, so dot submit. method we will call, right? Submit dot dot submit dot submit. Inside that again we will call one function. So here we will call one function. Function inside that function, what will be now? Okay, so good. Inside this function, we will call that validate product, right? Validate product. Okay, we will call that method. Which one? We took, right? We defined inside that the JavaScript what is this function, right? Validate product. This one we will call inside this event only, right? Now paste it. Okay. After then, we will check the condition here. We will check the condition. Okay. So what if what is that product code error, right? Product code error. It will return this method. Means this method will return what? Product code method equal this. This what? It will return what? If return true, then our what? Again, means what? Here we will get that message. Else, we will check the condition again, right? Else what? Return what? False. Else return what? False. Now, okay. So now our code is ready now. So let's run the application, guys. Okay, let's run our application. Let's see that. Okay, our code is working perfect. Again, I will explain because you know that why this code is looking like complicated, guys. Because who know that in JavaScript? For that, those people this is good, but who don't know JavaScript? Something like what magic is going on, right? So don't worry, again I will explain it. Okay, again I will explain it, this code. And separate session I will take for the what JavaScript, then and even what is that Ajax call also. Don't worry over this one. So now here, okay. Now refresh it.
I need to understand a little bit, feeling difficult, but we try.
Yeah, but you know Ajax. jQuery code, if who know that jQuery, right? Sorry, JavaScript and jQuery. Mobile I'm taking, right? Here this code is not there, right? No, first what we will do now, let's store some data, right? After then what? ADS I'm storing now, 20. Now RK, yes. Now I stored it, right? So here what, let's take mobile. Here I'm taking what? ADS, right? ADS we took.
No, AASD, you have taken AASD.
AASD. But we are not getting any, something wrong is there. Here we are not getting any messages.
If condition double equal miss, I think. Line number 19. In if condition double equal miss.
Where?
In line number 99.
Oh. Very good. The data also submit something wrong is there. 1 minute, right? So let's check it. Okay, refreshing. ADS. Okay, good. No issue. ADS.
AASD. AASD.
Okay. AASD.
You have given quotation again. Single quote you have given extra.
Line number two. Yes, three records are there, right? It's showing that. Okay, no issue. 1 minute, guys. Let's analyze it. Where I did mistake. This function is there, right? This function, what is that? Ready to and product code and a validate, right? Where this validate method is ending now? Be patient, guys. Okay, something wrong is going on, but we will complete it. Okay, because just a return type that we are like curly bracket, open bracket, because logic is correct. Something we did a wrong because it's not showing like whenever I'm clicking on that, which open bracket, curly bracket is which one, right? And the GSP page, because of that, if Java code is there, we can see that if we place this one, then it will show that, okay, for the else condition, this one is the close curly bracket, right? But here it's not showing that, okay? Because of that, I'm stucking. Else condition, inside that else condition, what I'm doing now here. This is our function, okay? Ajax function. Yeah, from here to here, copy this one. And paste inside this one. Okay, so now come to here. What is the problem now?